Mindy here. Welcome to your DMF Youth Mini Session number 12. Oh my gosh, so today I got your warm up and your follow along. Miss Liz has your daily step, Miss Mel has your combo, and Miss Toomey has your awesome human challenge. So grab everyone in the house, get ready to sweat, get ready to move, and get ready to feel awesome as we dance and learn together. All right, remember, it doesn't matter what you look like. If you're going that way and I'm going this way, who cares? It's about getting that energy up and the endorphins flowing and putting yourself in a great mood. So let's do it. Make sure you got some space to move, you got your water, and we're gonna get started. So warm up. We're gonna be doing a lot of running today. This song is called Back It Up. We did this once before. We're gonna do it again. And then the second song is our follow along. So just do your best. Here we go.
Back.
All right, here it comes.
Back, back, back. Back,
all right, I want you back, to just give back, me a little step
back,
and touch.
Back, back,
back,
back
it up,
back it up,
back. And
back,
now we're gonna start to back, run back, it out. I want you to run back, up towards me.
Back,
run, run,
back,
run. Now back it up,
back it up,
back it up.
Good.
Run towards me. Run it up,
run it up,
run it up. Now back it up,
back it up,
back it up. Woo! Step and clap. Are you giving it your own style? that double time. Heel, heel, heel. Yes! You're not going to be able to circle. Four circles, super slow. Three, make this your own. Anything you want, other way. Circle, circle. From the top. One, two, come on, you guys. Don't lose steam. You can do this. Cross, cross, and hook. Hook, double. Hey, again, salsa, two, three, cross it, one and two, three and four, five and six, jump it out to the side, woo, to the front, hey, in and out, yes, hook, love it, other side, hey, good, to the front, in and out, out. Yes, heel toe, and out together. See, I'm like rotating my foot, maybe take a pass, set. Yes, let's soften to the end. Hey, hey. If you want, take it front and back. Hold, front, yeah, maybe add a turn. Take a breath, in. And roll it up. You guys are so awesome. Take a breath. Get ready for Miss Liz and her daily step.
Whoa, was y'all in the freezer?
All right, now, what is up? It's Miss Liz back again with another daily step. Here again, I'm about to teach y'all how to do the hill and toe. You can do it to any song, you can put it in any dance, anything you want. Something easy, something basic. So, y'all ready to learn? Let's go.
Okay, so for today, we got a new different camera angle, so you have to see my feet. So now, hill and toe. We're gonna start off with your right, okay? You're gonna do your hill. One, hit, okay? You're gonna bring your left up. One, gonna bring your right back, boom, okay? Toe, okay? One, and two, and left leg now. Left leg goes out. One, and two, and. Okay? Let's try it again. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight, four. We go one, and two, three, and four. Here we go again. One, two, here we go. Three, and four. And make sure you twist your leg that goes out. So make sure you twist, hop, hop, twist, hop, hop, okay? Make sure that you are twisting on your heel, okay? And you're tapping on your toe. And you're scooting back on your right, your left, and when you switch it, your left goes out, twist, right goes down, boom, left goes back, boom, right goes back, okay? Let's try a little bit faster, a little bit, just a tad. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight, go, 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 and two, hit, and four, eight, one, and two, hit, three, and four. Okay? Let's slow it down a little bit. Five, six, seven, here we go, we go. One, and two, hit, three, and four. Just a side view, just in case. Here we go, slow. Five, six, seven, here we go. One, and two, and three, and four. Okay? Faster, side view. Three, five, six, seven, here we go. One, and two, hit three, and four. All right, you think we could try that with music? Let's try it.
Hey, yo, look like I'm going for a swim. Dunk on him, now I'm swinging off the rim. Coming off the bench while I'm coming off the court fully drenched. Here goes some hater rain, get your thirst quenched. Style doing them in this bird very trench. These birds copy every word, every inch. But gang gang got the hammer and the wrench. I pull up in that quarter milli off the lot. Oh, now she trying to be friends like I forgot.
Hey, yo, I been on, bitch, you been calm, bitch, listen, song, hey. All right, I hope y'all like y'all daily step.
I'll be back at y'all. Bye.
Hey, DMF viewers, Miss Mel here with your combo for the week. Thank you to Miss Liz for giving us that throwback step, the heel toe. The heel toe. And today we're going to put that in a combo. So, first eight count. Your feet are just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. So remember how we talked about our class? Single, single, double, double. That's what your feet are going to do. Start with your right. Single, single, double, double, single, single, double, double. Do it with me. Single, double, double, single, single, double, double. Good. Your arms are gonna kind of mimic that. Right, left, swing it around. Left, right, swing it around. Do it again. Right, left, big circle and hit. Left, right, big circle, and hit. So together, it should look like this, really slowly. Single, single, double, double. Single, single, double, double. Good, keep trying that with me. 5, 6, 7, 8. Single, single, double, double. Single, single, double, double. Good. Balance, keep holding. Now we're gonna go to a step that we've done before, that Miss Allie likes to do, or Miss Tumi likes to do. You're just gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but you're gonna change it up. Kick, ball, change. Do it again. You just finished your last single, single, double, double. You should be on your right foot, your left leg should be free. Free, free, free. 5, 6, 7, and 6, kick, ball, change. Now with this step, you should feel like you're falling, you should catch yourself. Whoa! Come back. Whoa! Come back. Whoa! Come back. Kick, ball, change. Let's try both of those 8 counts together. 5, 6, 7, 8. Single, single, double, double. Single, single, double, double. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Kickball change. Now when you're in this kick, with this last kickball change, I want you to be in this nice bent plie position. Then your knee is just gonna go in. Kind of like this step that we do, but we're on this angle. So in. And all this hand is gonna do is just crank it like this. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4. Uh-oh, Miss Mel forgot what's next. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you're gonna go knee 5, knee 6, hit 7, hit 8. Good. Back to this plie position, crank it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And when I see this, I want a nice strong arm up here and a nice strong arm around here, and my hands are in the blade. Kind of like when we tut it last week. Blades. Let's try all that from the beginning. 5, 6, 7, 8. Give 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 4. Hey, kick ball change. Kick ball change. Crank, 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 crank. Knee, knee, blades, blades. This is where Miss Liz dance comes in. You're gonna heel toe, but you're gonna go around in a circle. 1, 2, 3, 4. Kick the back. 6. Hit 7 with your right arm. Hit 8. So I want you to face back. Face the camera, the iPad, the TV. Face it again. So from the heel toe, you just did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stop on 6, 7, 8. So from the top, it should look like 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Fall, and fall, and fall. Kick, ball, change. Crank, 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 crank. Knee, knee, here we go. La, 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 la.
Welcome to your awesome human challenge. Now I hope you guys are all relaxed and or energized and ready to put your thinking caps on and get crafting. All right, now wherever you are in the room, I want you to just take a moment, take a deep breath in and let it out. And take a deep breath in again and let it out. And now we are ready to craft. Now, as Miss Lindy mentioned, today we are talking about kindness. And so today's awesome human challenge is an origami secret letter. All right. And what you're gonna need for this is super simple. You just need a pencil, hopefully with an eraser at the end of it, a ruler, a pen if you don't have a pencil, a pair of scissors, get mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, or auntie, uncle to help you out. And a piece of paper. All right, and let's get started. Now, as you're collecting all your stuff for a minute, or if you have your stuff already, let's just take a second to talk about kindness. Because one of the things I love most about kindness is that kindness can cure just about anything. It can cure me and it can cure you. One of the things that one of the ways kindness cures me is when someone does something kind for me, if I'm feeling sad or maybe if I had a hard day or even just because, you know, that makes me feel good. Another thing that actually makes me feel good, as well as makes other people feel good, is when I'm able to do something kind for someone else. All right, so today we are going to write our, we're going to make our secret, our origami secret letters for someone who we love or someone who we feel does something kind for us or makes us feel good about ourselves. So today I'm going to make my secret letter to Mr. Joey Bag of Donuts, my husband, because he makes me feel better even when I have a hard day or when I'm feeling sad. So let's get started. The first thing you want to do, take your ruler. I'm gonna move this down so we can see a bit better. Okay, great, see everything. You're going to take a ruler and you're going to take a pencil and you're just going to measure out a square on the one side. Remember, squares all have equal size. So on the one side, you're going to see how big do I want my square to be. And I like to make mine a little bit bigger than as opposed to a little bit smaller because it's just easier for me to work with and I can write more in my letter. All right, so now I've marked how big I want to make my square to be, want my square to be. And now I'm going to just use my pencil to draw the lines. And remember, even though we're making this on normal paper, you can always decorate it. I just had some normal blue pens, red pen, black pen, and so I just drew a little pattern on my white one. If you have other color papers, I have some color paper, so I made mine some color paper. You know, have fun with it. And then, now that I've got my square, I'm just going to cut my square out. And remember, ask mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, auntie, uncle, another, any adult who's around at home with you who can help to help you. All right. And now I have my square. Now I am ready to get folding. So let's make sure we've got a good view of our folding. Okay. All right. Now we want to turn our square in the shape to face us like a diamond, right? So we want the corners facing us. And then you're going to take the corners and you're going to fold them in to meet each other. There's one. Now I've got a triangle. And I'm going to unfold my triangle back to a diamond, turn it to face the other way, and fold it in half the other way. Trying to keep it as neat as possible. Ta-da! Now you should have four quarters. One, two, three, four. Okay. And now I'm going to, now that I have my four quarters, I'm going to turn my page to face me like a square. Okay. And I'm going to take the corner, one corner, and I'm going to fold the corner in so that the side, the edge of my paper comes to meet the line that I have in the middle of my page from folding it in half. So the line's going to come all the way up to meet. Remember, you can have an adult help you with this. I'm just going to fold that down. And then I'm going to do it again. And again, and again. On all four sides until all four of my sides have been folded. So I fold one side, that's two. That's three. Loosen that up there. And then that's four. Now that I have all my sides folded, guess what? We can write our message. I don't know if you can see it, but in there, in our folds, there is a square. So I'm gonna use my black pen to draw the square out so you can see it. Here we go. Here's our square, our little message box. Can you see it? Very cool, right? Look at that. Ta-da! Message box. So now I am going to write my message to Mr. Bag of Donuts. Let's see. Dear Mr. Joey Bag of Donuts, thank you for always being a great friend. Your jokes make me laugh even when I am sad or had a hard day. I can't wait to watch a fun movie with you again. Love, Mrs. Toomey Bag of Donuts. Awesome. Great. Now I've got my letter. Now it's time to fold it up again. So, I'm gonna put in the square again. Ends facing me. Fold one side in. Since I already have my lines there, I know exactly where to fold. Fold the other side in. And fold my third side in. And now I'm going to fold my fourth side in, but I'm just going to fold it in really quickly on that line that I've made there so I can see exactly where that line is. But now it's going to get a bit tricky because now I'm going to unfold it and then I'm going to lift the corner of the first side that I folded and tuck the corner in all the way to my fold line so that I tuck that last side in underneath. Let's see if we can look at that on our sample page here. So we've got a little dotted line. So we got a line here. So we fold on this dotted line, fold the side in to come to our dotted line across the middle, fold the three sides in, and then when we fold the last side in, right there where we have the red lines there, our little red dotted line, we're going to fold that crease in, we're going to tuck that in so we meet on the blue line right here. It's a little bit faint. I'm going to tuck that in nicely as we fold it on our line so that our last side is tucked in. Right. And now we're going to just turn it over. Very good. Now we're going to take the corner, turn it into a diamond again, take the corners and fold them in to the center. I know you can see that little center mark there, right? So fold it in one side, other side, that's two. Three. And four. How we doing? Doing great. Awesome. Ta-da! Okay. And now we're going to unfold it one more time. Unfold, there we go. And flip it around again. Now, we're going to do something a little bit challenging. We're going to lift the corner. And we're going to fold. We're going to just tuck and fold this end in. Fold. Very good. Very nice. Tuck and fold one more time. And where we're tucking and folding to is where we folded into before. All right, so remember we folded our lines in this side. Okay, now we've unfolded, turned it around, and now we are lifting, tucking, and folding right there on the blue dotted line from when we folded it into the center. Tuck and fold again. On all four sides. Very nice. Keep going. Last side. Tucking and folding. Lifting it up. Very good. How are we doing? Look like a pinwheel. Okay, last step. You are going to take this end and fold it back on itself, but we're folding it back to meet this line and to meet the line on the underneath. Can we see our line there? I'm going to fold it back to meet the line. So take the end and fold it back. Meet that line, press it down very nicely. See if I can show you here again. So, unfolded, and we've tucked on our light blue line, tucking away, tucking all the way in, all the way in, all the way in. All the way in, last one. And then right here on our black line, see our black dotted line, we're going to fold that in to come to meet the inside fold line there. All right, so let's fold that in. That's one fold, got one more. Well, three more really. Two. Three, and last one, four, et voila! We have our origami secret note. Now, I am going to take my origami secret notes and leave them in a secret little spot for Mr. Peck. See you guys next time. Good luck with your awesome human challenge and show us what you can do. Yay!